Welcome to the set of Angel of the Skies. I'm Nicholas van der Bijl, play Captain Earl Kirk, and we're in the last week of filming.
There we go, it's nice.
Now let's mark that board.
1187 is audio, eh? Thank you. So Angel of the Skies is a story about a South African pilot, Captain Earl Kirk, who is kind of thrust into the crossroads of, you know, of life and death when him and his crew are, you know, shot down over Nazi Germany. And, you know, we get thrust into this world of them of boys becoming men. I mean, that's essentially what it is. It's young guys, age 18 to 20, flying these massive metal monstrosities over, you know, other cities, dropping bombs on them. And, you know, these guys get shot down, crash land in enemy territory, and they've got to try and make their way home. And I mean, that is an experience where people, you know, really mature really quickly. And we definitely see that from the beginning of the film to the end.
My name is Andre Frauenstein. I play the character Lieutenant Raymond Hawkins. He is the sort of the outsider of the whole crew that goes on this mission into Germany, Bremen. And he's the co-pilot. And he's on a constant battle with Captain Earl. Just basically, you know, he's like, my character's like the hotshot, and he wants to take control of the whole tour, of the whole flight. And he always thinks that his decisions are the correct decisions, whereas Captain Earl doesn't know what he's doing because he's a South African pilot.
Yes, fuel pump to engine 2 and feather the prop. It's not doing anything, Captain. We need to dive.
Not yet.
We need to dive or we're going to lose her.
I said not yet.
With all due respect, Captain, if that engine blows, we're all as good as dead.
Give her a few more seconds, Lieutenant.
No, we don't have a few more seconds.
Take your hands off that steering column, Lieutenant. That's an order.
Basically, all of the actors that are working on this film, they're all great guys. They all know each other. I haven't actually met them until we got on set. They're all actually friends, but it's quite nice for my character as well, because I am the outsider.
Flight Officer Earl, this is your new co-pilot, Lieutenant Raymond Hawkins. Straight out of flight school, top of his class. I'm sure he'll fit in perfectly.
Yes, sir, we'll see to it that he does.
Good. Any questions, Lieutenant?
Commander, I was informed that I would have my own flight crew. I wasn't aware that we had any foreigners in the unit.
Are you referring to Captain Kirk, Lieutenant? The captain here is a volunteer from the South African Air Force and one of the best men we have.
My name's David James and I play Schutz. I'm an SS officer for the Nazis. Schutz is a intense, he truly isn't an intense being. I got a phone call from Chris and said, I'm not sure if you're available, and I met Andrew McDonald for the first time, who's a producer on the set. And Chris said, I don't know if you'll be interested in playing another badass individual. I said, why not? It seems to be my trademark. It's a small part. Schutz is introduced towards the end of the movie, and his function is to hunt down and kill. He's cold-blooded, and he's typically SS.
Ich glaube, sie sind Richtung Westen gegangen.
Wie viel?
5. Eine war schwer verletzt. Er schien in den Beinen verletzt zu sein, vielleicht vom Flugzeugunfall.
Working with Chris De Santos is always interesting. I mean, I've worked with him a number of times and brings a great vision to films. I mean, people tell him he can't do this and he can't do that, but he goes for it. I mean, he has the balls to do it, which is great. Especially on a film like this with such a small budget, it's been a massive challenge, but at no point has he felt like giving up or felt like he couldn't do it. He just goes for it, which is great. As an actor, he gives you a lot of free rein with your character. If he doesn't like what he sees, he tells you. He's very picky with that, but it's very much open to your own interpretation, which is great. I mean, you do the research, you do the preparation, and you come onto set, and you give him your best take of the character, and if he likes it or not, he'll tell you. But it's great as an actor because it really gives you free expression to take that character where you want.
Angel of the Scars basically started, 2009. I'd just come back from, I'd been staying in Los Angeles for a while. I'd been there for quite some time. I'd met quite a lot of young other filmmakers, and they all seemed to have this really good visual effects background that seemed to have like just got them far in life. So I was like, you know, maybe I should teach myself some visual effects. Ended up coming back from Los Angeles back to South Africa, and I thought to myself, now I'm going to take a year off and I'm just going to teach myself visual effects. And that's all I did for the whole of 2009, is just train. I did a few edit jobs here and there to make money to help buy another piece of equipment or whatever, just to help get those tutorials and keep teaching myself. But there was one tutorial that really stood out, which was teaching how to do realistic clouds and getting aircraft to fly through them. And, I finished doing this visual effects shot and I put it up on my Facebook at the time. And I got quite a lot of people saying to me, this visual effects shot looks so real. Like, where did you shoot this plane? I'm going, no, this is actually a computer generated. This was made on my computer in my bedroom. This isn't real. And that got me thinking, maybe I can do a short film. I can do like a little short movie about a British or a South African pilot versus a German pilot. Have a little dog fight. And, that's essentially where Angel of the Sky started, as just a 10-minute short film. So, I called up my friend Nick from the Bell. He studied with me at AFTA, and we started meeting about doing this short film. We went out to SWAT Corps Air Force Base to start looking up for certain planes to use, and we found the Spitfire cockpit. Great, we're going to start with that. We found some uniforms, and this was meant to be a 10-minute film. And geez, I just couldn't stop writing. The script just getting like longer and longer and longer, and what actually then happened, it became like a snowball effect.
Basically, I met Chris on a set of another movie, eventually we started chatting about this interesting project that he had going called Angel of the Skies. It immediately caught my attention because from my family background, my dad used to be a Luftwaffe pilot in the German Luftwaffe and the German Air Force in the Second World War. And he had quite a few narrow escapes and a few very interesting stories. So immediately this project seemed very attractive to me from a historical point of view and from a sentimental point of view. Also, besides the point that it's not every day that sort of a really epic movie comes your way, which lends itself to really the type of music that I enjoy and love making.
Once we got that script down, I started meeting with a lot of the other young actors. I mean, the main five guys of the film are guys that studied at film school with me. And we would meet up, you know, we'd have nights, we'd sit down with the script, we'd read through it, and, you know, they'd give me back their feedback. And then I'm the first one to abandon my own plan if someone has like a better plan that's going to help the project or help the story. And, yeah, it's just, I think it just made the script a lot better having these meetings. 2010 went past, and a lot of progression had been done on making the prep for the film, but now it was actually now time to actually try shooting the film. You know, I'd saved up a lot of money on previous jobs I'd done. I bought my own cameras, systems, and lights, and, you know, basically I was totally independent in trying to make this film. And a lot of the cast and crew and guys were just so passionate in trying to make this film. They all were just trying to help me get it made. And so I got a phone call one day from a person named Dione Kempen. I'd worked with him on previous jobs before. I actually used to edit for him while I was in film school. And so he called me up and said, "Hey, what's happening with your movie? You know, you've been working on it for so long. What's going on?" And I said, "Look, I'm still trying to get it made. I still need a bit of money." So, you know, he said, "How much do you need?" I gave him a ballpark figure, and he said, "Cool, let's go, let's do it." And I was like, "What? Okay, are you serious? Let's go." And that was that. That was the story. I mean, 3 months later, we were on set shooting.
Well, I'm getting my makeup done and getting some scars and bumps and things because we were just in an accident.
Yeah. I tripped, hit my head. You know, Chris is a very good director. You know, he really tries to get what he can out of you. So, you know, apparently I didn't say the lines right. So
he smacked you.
Yeah, he's right though.
It's the first time I've acted with you.
Yeah. In how many years?
I know, we've known each other for years. First time I acted with you.
Yeah.
It's been great. It was exciting from day one when I knew I was going to act with you guys. Nick van der Bijl, our lead actor.
It's great working with actors that have a fresh mentality, you know. They come to the ball game with a new set of rules and it's
exciting times. We're all young, so.
It's fresh. As fresh as they come. What do you expect?
So, let's get to more important matters. How much is the wager tonight?
Oh, come now, Ed. I thought, you know, we could, you know, take a break, relax, and enjoy ourselves.
That's exactly what this evening is about. Right, boys? Enjoying ourselves. So, who's the target?
There's no target. Target?
Robbie?
It's a lass at the end there, sir.
Good boy, Robbie. How much was it again?
50.
I thought you said 40.
40.
No, well, too late, too late. 50 it is, 50 it is.
Bollocks to you, Ed.
But he bastard, he always does.
Enjoyed the set with the comedy. We've, like we said earlier, alter egos and personas coming out in the board times.
Is that a test? Is that a test to show?
Just Don over here.
Dwayne?
Hello, Don.
Twit.
Fairy.
Director.
When you are on set for quite a while and you see all the little personalities coming out. Yeah, yeah. And I don't think there's been one occasion where it hasn't been fun. Like, we've always had a good time.
Yeah.
I think I do draw certain similarities between my character and myself. I'm very disciplined as an actor, and I think that helps a lot with the character because he's very disciplined, he's very on the ball, very clinical. I mean, he's a bomber pilot, so he has to be. Everything has to be on point, otherwise he wouldn't be making these missions to and back from Germany without having survived this far. He has a life of a crew in his hands as well as the pilots, and that also leads to him being very clinical and responsible. And I think I am a very responsible person in my jobs and the undertakings I have with friends and family, and that comes across in the character, I think.
The shoot's been great. It's been a privilege working with Chris Dos Santos. I studied with Chris at film school, at AFTER Film School, and he's been passionate about this project for years. Pre-production's been a long process. It's been a passion project for a while, and he's got together this brilliant crew. Andrew McDonald, the producer, has done a great job. Got an awesome cast, and from day one, it's just been a good vibe on set. Bunch of young filmmakers just doing their thing on set. It's quite fun. We had the Aussies on set. We had two Australians on set, which was pretty cool. Adam Boyes and Lily Clare, very talented actors. They just brought something different to the set, which was pretty cool. And they taught us South African actors something different on set, which was pretty cool.
G'day. I was told to report to the 150th Squadron. To report to Captain Earl's flight crew. I'm the new replacement, just come in from bomber training.
Well, he's the worst director in this country. I've said it before and I'll say it again, that working with Chris has been fun, always. Cinematography, he has an astute eye for. He wrote the script, and it's a good script. And when we were working on another project about a year and a half ago, he mentioned it in a sort of a by-the-by way. And it's ironic that it's turned out that he's asked me to do this production with him as well. I don't think I've ever worked with Chris without him killing me off. And there's always a sexual undertone in the characters he casts me in. I think somehow he thinks I should be a psychotic individual in real life. But I've got respect for Chris. He's a young and up-and-coming talent in this country, and I would support him in any way I possibly can.
The music for Angel of the Skies was composed by a gentleman named Guido Hahn. He is German, of German descent, classically trained. And I had met him on a film in 2010 called The Racist. And he had actually done the music for that film. You know, on the passing, I had mentioned to him, you know, I've got this movie I want to make, Angel of the Skies, World War II film. And he was like, because his father actually flew in the Luftwaffe. So, you know, for him, this was a very close to heart story. And it was pretty much a massive passion project for him. So he actually ended up hounding me, coming after me, and kept reminding me, do you still want me to do the music? Which is great. I mean, you want to have people like that who are passionate to work on your film. You don't want to end up with people that are just trying to get the paycheck done. You want to end up with people that are doing a story because they love it.
Eventually, we honed it down to exactly what he was looking for in terms of to not only drive the drama forward and drive the film forward, but really to capture a bit of the spirit of that time, a bit of the excitement and the feel of the 40s. And I must say, I really, at the end of the day, the whole film came, and the whole musical score came out to exactly what we imagined in the beginning, which I'm very, very happy about. Obviously, what was great is Chris's ability to place music and to give me input in terms of cues, specifically the timing and certain things, which really was also very, very helpful in terms of the direction. But in general, I would say it was a long process. We spent on and off 2 years.
Gear was just there from day one, and I'd met with him in 2010, many months after Racist. I mean, we're talking a year before even going into shooting Angels. Gio and I were already sitting down laying the basics of the soundtrack and things that I wanted. And I mean, Gio is so, he's got an ear, hey man, he just knows what works for a scene. And you know, there were days we were sitting down and I'd sit with the movie and I'd go, yeah, Gio, I don't know if what I really want you. And he'd say, cool, let me just play around with it. And I'd come in the next morning and man, I had goosebumps watching these scenes going, that's perfect, that is it, that is the sound, that is Stutz's theme, that is it, that really brings out his character.
Really, I think, bought into his vision at that point. Even before I saw any of the cuts of the film, I was really excited. I saw the script. It really intrigued me, and I couldn't wait to see, you know, sort of the first CGI work coming out. Needless to say, when I start seeing the first cuts, I was really, really blown away by the quality and the attention to detail and that I saw.
Let's just say, for instance, I wanted, you know, the sound of a train, you know, he would bring it into the song, and but in a sense he would use an instrument to play that sound, and it just sounded so menacing and really helped the music push the story forward. Music and sound for me are just as important as picture, and if you don't pay as much attention to those things, you're never going to have a movie that's complete.
I stand corrected, but I don't think there has been South African production like this before. I know that they've shot documentaries from both the BBC side and from Sky, and Discovery's done about 3 or 4 documentaries in the country on South Africans who fought and did bundle for Britain, because we were a colony then. In this case, shooting an English film in South Africa during the Second World War, that's a first. Secondly, from a storytelling point of view, Chris has got a very special heart behind this story. And friendship is important in this.